feared above all gods, for all the gods of the nations are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. Give unto the Lord, O ye kindreds of the people, give unto the Lord glory and strength. Give unto him glory and strength. It means when you worship God, worship him with everything that lies within you. Hallelujah. Give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name. Give, bring an offering and come into his courts. Oh, worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Fear before him all the earth. Say among the heathen that the Lord reigneth. The world also shall be established, that it shall not be moved. He shall judge the people righteously. Let the heavens rejoice, and let the earth be glad. Let the sea roar, and the fullness thereof. Let the fields be joyful, and all that is therein. Then shall all the trees of the wood rejoice before the Lord, for he cometh. For he cometh to judge the earth.
Amen.
He shall judge the world with righteousness, and the people with his truth. Hallelujah. How many know the Lord is coming?
Yes.
He's coming. He's coming. Hallelujah. The Bible says, let everyone that doesn't believe this gospel and doesn't follow this gospel be accursed. And then he ends it with, in 1 Corinthians, Maranatha. Maranatha. Maranatha, the Lord cometh. When we was in Africa, for some years, when we were a joint mission, we went under the name of Maranatha. The Lord cometh. That's the Greek word for the Lord cometh. I want everyone to turn to somebody and say, Maranatha.
Maranatha.
Say, the Lord cometh. The Lord cometh. Hallelujah. Wouldn't it be wonderful if this morning, I mean, the signs and the times, all the things that are happening, if you've been studying, we've got a prophecy in the year of Jubilee last week, and the seasons of that we're looking at, I believe with all my heart, during the Feast of the Trumpets, it could be at any time that the Lord would just break forth and be here in the moment in the twinkling of an eye. And I want to be ready. I want to be singing praises to him. I want to be honoring him. I want to be having a new song in my heart. I want to be having something fresh with God. I want to be walking with him, living in the Spirit. Hallelujah. Being led by the Spirit when the Lord cometh. And he's going to come, and maybe today. Wouldn't it be wonderful, right, at this service, if the Spirit of God would come down and just quicken us and take us to be with him. It's going to happen someday. Let's live in that expectation and believe that it could be today for the glory of God. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord is good. For us, just to come and want to pray. God says, bring an offering when you come into the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Bring an offering. We should come not to just offer the praise, but an offering to give. And when they did that in the Jewish times, they bring an offering every time they came to the temple. And one time we got so much that Moses said, okay, it's enough. It's enough. We don't need anymore. Wow.
Amen.
We've never had that situation here at Bethel. But I know this. If the needs are many, and I thank God for a church that gives 10% of our income goes overseas. 10% goes around the world over that. Actually, sometimes we've averaged over 21% that we've sent abroad, counting our offerings and everything for special missions. And I thank the Lord for a church that gives and gives and gives. It's not about us. It's about the kingdom of God. It's not about Bethel. It's about the work of God around the world. And so what you give today, we take 10% right off immediately. And that is dispersed various parts of the world. And we thank the Lord for that. So thank you for your giving. And let's bless God this morning. Amen. What if we could just stand and just bless him. Bless him and praise him with all of our strength and give him honor this morning. Lord, we lift up our hands to you. We lift up our voices, God. We lift up our hearts to you, God. We ask you to bless and to move and to minister today in a very special way. And Lord, we ask you to bless this offering, God, as it's given to you, Lord, with hearts filled with joy and appreciation for all that you've done and are doing for us even today. Oh, Lord, minister by the power of your Spirit throughout this service, God, and honor, Lord, the hearts of your people that come to you in faith believing. And, Lord, I'll thank you for it. Now, bless, Lord, each giver. Bless the gift And bless, Lord, the work here at Bethel.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we'll praise you for it. We ask it in Jesus' name. And everyone said,
amen.
Amen. Shake hands with that one next to you and keep your offering in the video. And God bless you.
Thank you. Your praise will ever be on my lips. ever be on my lips, your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips.
Thank you.
us, and let the praise of the Lord be continually, continually on your lips, day and night, day and night. You should rise with praise. You should lie down with praise. You should wake up in the midnight with praise, day and night. Let your incense arise, worshiping and adoring and honoring you. For he and he alone is worthy of all praise. Hallelujah. 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 Lord, we thank you for your presence here. Lord, wherever your presence is, there is liberty. And in your presence, there is fullness of joy. Hallelujah. You and you alone can put the smile on our face that is eternal. You and you alone can give a peace that passes all understanding. You and you alone, O Lord, are the God that reigns upon the earth. Lord, in the heavens, your yes is yes, your no is no, and all things are under your control. We thank you, Lord. You are God. There's no other God like you. Lord, we bow our hearts to you this morning, knowing that, Lord, you are the answer to every need in our life. Without you, we have no hope. Without you, there is no faith. Without you, Lord, there is no life. It's in you and you alone, Lord. It's in you alone this morning. And our trust is in you. So many needs in this body, Lord, that is weak. This body of believers is going through so many trials and tests and difficulties, Lord. Even as we gather to worship you in faith, we know, Lord, that some of the faith in this place is being tested and tried by the fires. I pray, oh God, you administer this morning. Lord, you help us to come through the fires like pure gold. And the Lord, we would have a testimony that would glorify and magnify you for your faithfulness, even in the fire. We bring duty to you, Lord, going in for surgery, even tomorrow for cancer, God. Let it be a successful surgery. Let the cancer be removed, Lord. Make it possible. Work a miracle, Lord, for Judy right now. We bless you for it. We bring Louise, Lord, going through similar surgery, even on Wednesday. This family's being attacked so strongly by the enemy, Lord. We ask you to, Lord, bring them through this operations and all that they're facing this week gloriously. Lord, let us have a great report next week. God, that there's no cancer, there's no other afflictions, and that there's health and healing to this family. And we'll praise you for it, Lord. We lift up so many that are going through struggles and battles this morning. God, they're seems like things are falling apart in their life. I pray, God, you'd help them to look to you, to trust in you, not to run from you, but to run to you. Lord, to find that in you, Lord, and you alone, we have our strength. And I will bless you for that. We ask you to anoint Brother Mike, even as he brings the word this morning. Even in weakness, you said he would be made strong. And in the power of your might, may he minister the word this morning. May the power of your Spirit, O God, may he, Lord, bring to us truth that will make us free, truth that will liberate us, truth that will strengthen us, truth, O Lord, from your word that will excite us, Lord, to live for you and you alone. Anoint him. Anoint him this morning. And I will bless you for it in Jesus' name. And everyone say,
amen.
God bless you. You may be seated. Appreciate the presence of the Lord, your worship, and all that God has blessed us with here in Bethel. God is good, isn't he?
Yeah.
We want to be doing a series on living in the Spirit. It's been going on in Galatians 5:25. If you live in the Spirit, then walk in the Spirit. And sometimes the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak, Jesus said. But I thank God for some soldiers on the cross that even when their flesh is so weak, when I call them, their spirit is, yes, brother, I would love to bring the Word of God, even though I know it's coming forth in weakness of body, but in strength of the Spirit. And we appreciate my friend Brenda, all that they've been through these last 6-7 years of their life, the cancer they battled, Guillain-Barré. I was talking to somebody the other day about you, and they never heard of that. I said, well, that's good. None of us have ever heard of it until Brenda got it. And I said, man, that is unbelievable. That was not attacking me, never. But God has brought them through all of this and still is bringing them. And if I can deliver the word of God to us this morning. Let's give him a hand clap.
Hallelujah. I get special treatment because I get a table and a chair. Hallelujah. I tell you what, church. We're in the end of days.
Yes, indeed.
And if anyone could deny that, I'd like to take you to a psych ward at Alton State Hospital.
Amen.
Because all you have to do is look around and see. We are approaching quickly. The last minute. We're past the last hour. But we are approaching the last minute. We just went through the Feast of Trumpets. And the scripture teaches that at the last trump, the dead in Christ shall rise. Woo! Hallelujah. The dead in Christ shall rise. And that we that are alive and remain will be caught up together with him in the air. And we'll meet Jesus in the air. We'll ever be with him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And it's an interesting fact about the last trump. Because it has to do with the Feast of Trumpets. In the Feast of Trumpets, it lasts for 2 days. But in each of those days, the priests blow the trumpet 9 times every hour. And at the last, whenever it comes to the last day, they blow it 9 times. And then at the very last one, it's the last trump. It sounds long, it's pronounced, and it signals the end of the Feast of Trumpets. And God is just about ready to send, I believe, the trump of God to this earth that we live in. Amen?
Amen,
amen, amen, amen. You know, you want to preach on something, then God goes ahead and preaches it right before you, right in front of you, while you're watching it with your eyes. Our prayer was that God would move this morning. People would worship like never before. That they would enter into a place where God only dwells by His Spirit.
Yes.
And I heard a pleasant sound today. A beautiful sound from the hearts and the spirits of God's people. When this place was filled with worship, when this place was filled with praise, when people came to the altar under the presence of the mighty Spirit of God and knelt before His presence and cried out, God, you've got to come visit. You've got to come. You've got to arise in this place. You've got to bring conviction. You've got to bring change. You've got to bring it. By your Spirit.
Yes.
And we saw it happen.
God is good, baby. We
saw it happen, man. Yes. Saw it happen. I don't know where to go with this thing now. God just blew my whole thing. So we'll just go like it was not even, like God didn't even do something here, but He already did. Anyway. One of the things that we have promised of is that we would receive power. After that, the Holy Ghost has come upon you. You shall receive power. Power to what? Where?
In all the earth.
That includes your next door neighbors. That includes the
guy that's waiting on you at the cash register, the people that you see every day. We've got these pennies out there that are perfect to be a witness. And everybody that we've been giving those things to has never turned one down. They've never thrown them in the ground. They've never done anything like that. They've just said, thank you so very much. Thank you for thinking of us. Thank you for thinking of me. Thank you for this coin. You shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. You shall be my witnesses unto me in Jerusalem and all of Judea and Samaria to the uttermost part of the earth. But while they were waiting in the upper room, they were commanded to go there. While they were waiting, it said, when the day of Pentecost was fully come. Fully come. Sometimes God wants you to wait until a day is fully come. Until you think the promise can't possibly arrive in time. But when the day of Pentecost was fully come, the promise arrived. And sometimes when we're going through things in our lives, we don't understand why we're going through. We don't understand what caused it or anything else. But when the day of our promise is fully come, when it seems like it's being put off, the Spirit of God will bring the promise to pass. Amen?
Amen.
When they were there with one accord, and sometimes that's what God is waiting for us to be in, is one accord. Sometimes unity takes precedence over our availability. Sometimes we have to come together and whenever we're not even available, sometimes have to press past our availability and say, hey, no matter what it takes, no matter what it costs, no matter where I have to go, no matter what I have to say, no matter who I have to meet, no matter when I have to be there, my availability is to you, God, and you, God, alone. And I will be there in unity with the brethren that you've called me to be together with. Amen?
Amen.
When it presses past what we think our availability is, and it goes into what God wants, no matter what. There came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. You know, sometimes it's not just the speaking in tongues. Sometimes it's the worship in tongues.
Yes.
Sometimes it's the lifting of hands like we did in here this morning. Worshiping with the Lord our God with our hands lifted. Speaking in tongues, worshiping in tongues, singing the song that comes out of us by the Spirit of God. I know Tisha wants that more than anything in this house. She wants people to be able to stand up and start to begin to sing and say, Oh, Remeshi Paramo, Ribashi Rebaramandre, Ribashaparagurie. And begin to sing in the Spirit. Begin to worship Him in the glory of His presence. What about a church that does that? If the animals can sing it, if crickets can do it, why can't we, as God's highest creation, sing like nobody's business in the presence of God Almighty? Sing a song that has not been heard before, and then let somebody begin to interpret that song, and let them sing it in the Spirit, and let those things begin to happen in the house of God. I want to tell you, some people will come in here and say, where is the move that I've heard about? Where is the move of the Spirit that I've heard about from this place? And somebody ought to have an interpretation anyway of what I just did. How about that? Somebody got it? Tish, you got something? You got it? Okay. Anyway, because there's supposed to be an interpretation of that as well. So, anyway, but that's what God wants us to do, is come in here with a joyful sound, with a song in our heart, just like what he said, let us, we'll go back there and read that again, it's Psalms. Psalms 96. There's a, what God wants us to do. Well, Michael, here we go. Sing unto the Lord a new song. Sing unto the Lord all the earth. Sing unto the Lord, bless his name, show forth his salvation from day to day. Sing unto the Lord a new song. Who here wants to sing a new song? Amen. I want to sing a new song. See, us singing in tongues is mere practice for what we're going to be singing before the throne of God. It'll be a perfect language. It'll be a perfect song. It'll be glorious to our King. And nothing will interfere with what we have to do before His presence. God wants us to sing a new song. I thought, wait, I said, what Brother Roy got up and started that, I said, oh my God, that's one of the scriptures I was going to use. So we must be on the same wavelength anyway. Anyway, God wants His people to sing a new song. Some people come in with a song, some with a teaching, some with a song. Other things that people come in with, you know, we're supposed to come in and bring these things all together. So that whenever we come together, Jesus is magnified and glorified in a special way. Unlike anything we've ever seen hitherto. So God wants us to do that, all right? If Pentecost was fully come, they were with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as a sound of a rushing mighty wind. And these guys were all baptized in the Holy Ghost and began to speak in tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And I wonder if everybody here that calls themselves a part of Bethel Pentecostal Church, have you all received the baptism in the Holy Spirit?
Yes.
Are we all baptized in the Holy Ghost? Do we all speak with tongues? Do we all speak with tongues?
No.
If you say you have received the baptism in the Holy Spirit, the evidence of the incoming and the inflowing of the Holy Ghost is the speaking with tongues. God wants you full. God wants you speaking in a language that the devil cannot interpret. God wants you speaking in a language that only He knows and you know, and you can communicate on a level that is in the Spirit. So before we go today, we're going to ask for people to come up front. We're going to lay hands on you to receive the baptism in the Holy Ghost. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Don't want anybody going out of here with that. It's like being saved, man. For a Spirit-filled Christian, got to have that Holy Ghost. Got to have that Spirit. First Corinthians 14, 21, 22. The Bible says this, it is written, with men of other tongues and other lips will I speak unto this people. And yet for all that, they will not hear me, saith the Lord. Wherefore tongues are for a sign, not to them that believe, but to them that believe not. So this, when people hear you speak in tongues, it's a sign for people that don't believe. And so it's necessary for this church, to be filled with the Holy Ghost. We've got a sign out front that says Pentecostal. That's what we're supposed to be. Amen?
Yes.
Amen. So let us come to the Lord today at the end of this thing. We're going to get you baptized in the Holy Ghost. John had some disciples, and they were in the line. Paul was going through the countryside, Paul said, he asked them, what baptism were you? And they said, we're of John's baptism. And Paul said, well, haven't you guys heard of the Holy Spirit or the power of God? They said, no, only John's baptism. So they laid hands on them, and they received the Holy Ghost. And they spoke with tongues as everybody else had done prior to that time. There was about 12 people, the Bible says, in that gathering. And they all spoke with tongues. And so...